सो इंडिविजुअल डिजास्टर प्रिपेयरनेस, वी विल कॉल इट एज इंडिविजुअल डिजास्टर प्रिपेयरनेस बिकॉज एज एन इंडिविजुअल यू शुड बी एबल टू नो द बेसिक डूज एंड डोंट्स ड्यूरिंग द डिजास्टर सिचुएशन. सो एज आई टोल्ड यू, दिस PDF इज गिवन बाय द डिस्ट्रिक्ट डिजास्टर मैनेजमेंट अथॉरिटी ऑफ अनंतनाग विच इज इन जम्मू कश्मीर. ओके, सो वेन यू टॉक अबाउट फ्लड्स, सो यू नो, नाउ यू नो वॉट इज अ फ्लड, राइट? I don't need to explain you much into it. We have seen about various types of disasters, so you know the flood-like situation. Even from this particular picture, you can make out floods. What is that? Okay. So, we ought to be smart and prepared to tide over a flood, to overcome this flood. Some ways are before floods. Okay, before, since you know a particular area is vulnerable to floods. Like I told you, we know Mumbai is vulnerable to floods during rainy season. So before the flood, how you should be individually prepared? To prepare for a flood, you should avoid building in flood-prone areas unless you elevate and reinforce your home. Elevate the furnace, water heater, electric panel if susceptible to flooding. Right? That is very important. Elevate, that is, raise their height. Install check walls in sewer traps to prevent the flood water from backing up into the drains of your home. Contact community officials to find out if they are planning to construct any barriers, that is any wall, any levees, beams, flood walls, to stop the flood water from entering the homes in your area. Seal the walls in your basement with waterproofing compounds to avoid seepage. So all these things you can do before the occurrence of the flood. Okay, so that the impact of that flood would be reduced even if you are susceptible, that is vulnerable to such situation. So that was before flood. When flood is likely to hit, ignore the rumors, stay calm and don't panic. Stay available, that is keep your mobile phones charged for emergency communication, use SMS. Be alert, listen to radio, watch TV, read newspapers for weather updates, for warnings, early warnings, right? Don't ignore the animals. Along with your own individual health and individual preparedness, you should always also take care of the animals nearby, that is the keep cattle or the animals untied to ensure their safety, right? Survival is the key. Prepare an emergency kit with essential items for safety and survival. Save your valuables. Very important, keep your documents and valuables in waterproof bags. Okay, so when flood is likely to hit, it's going to hit. Okay, so the simple steps you can follow. And main important, ignore the rumors and make yourself aware of the situation. Okay, then after the flood, or basically during the floods, we'll see first during the floods. Okay, when flood is likely to hit, now next is during the floods. Don't take risk. Don't enter the flood waters in case you need to wear suitable footwear. Correct? Of course, purposely do not enter into the flood water, and obviously wear footwear when you have to enter into it. Watch your step. Stay away from sewerage lines, gutters, drains, culverts, etc. because it is completely covered with the flood water. So you never know where there is a sewer line, where there is a gutter, where there is an open chamber. Okay, so watch your step. Don't get electrocuted. That is electric poles. They are likely to have the short circuiting during the floods. Okay, so stay away from electric poles and fallen power lines to avoid electrocution. Then, remain healthy. Eat freshly cooked or dry food. Keep your food covered. Evade illness. Drink boiled or chlorinated water. Because we know when such flood situation occurs, the very first thing following the flood happens is spread of diseases. Right? Unhealthy items, food items, or contaminated food items, contaminated water. So, that gives rise to epidemic, that is spread of diseases. So that is why remain healthy, eat healthy, freshly cooked, drink boiled water, chlorinated water, ensure cleanliness, use disinfectants to keep your surroundings clean, because when the flood occurs, the germs, the spread of diseases, right? So ensure cleanliness. Then this is during the floods. Okay, after the flood occurs, protect the children. Do not allow children to play in or near the flood water. Don't use any damaged electrical goods. Get them checked. Very important. Okay, watch your step. Watch out for broken electric poles and wires, sharp objects and debris, any waste. Okay, see what you eat. Do not eat food that has been in flood waters. Of course, mosquitoes can use mosquito nets to prevent malaria. Use clean water, because malaria follows the flood situation. Okay, then use clean water. Don't use the toilet or the tap water. Then, if you need to evacuate from that place, the flood situation has worsened, and if you need to evacuate or your particular home, that area, raise the furniture, appliances on bed and table. Of course, you need to elevate them so that they don't get damaged due to the flood water. So raise the furniture, appliances on beds and tables. Put sandbags in the toilet bowl and cover all the drain holes to prevent the sewage backflow. Turn off the power and gas connection. Move to a higher ground or safe shelter. Take the emergency kit, first aid box and valuables with you. Do not enter deep unknown waters. Use a stick to check the water depth. Come back home when only when the officials ask you to do so. Okay, so when you need to evacuate, the situation has worsened, that water has started entering it at your homes. So you need to evacuate that particular area, and for that, these steps you need to keep in mind and follow. So this is the basic. See, all these things do not require a training, right? It is just the awareness and alertness in that situation, correct, that it requires. So this is the basic do's and don'ts that you should keep in your mind when flood-like situation occurs. Rather than being panic and worrying about the situation and being dependent upon the only the officials, at your individual step, at individual place, what steps you can follow. So these are some simple steps. Similarly, when earthquake occurs, okay, when earthquake occurs, what are the simple do's and don'ts? So here one thing we have seen in this picture. The students are under the desk. Why? Because we have reading it and this from, you know, our school level as well. That basic thing that you can do when you are in the earthquake-like situation. Cover yourself under some hard table or desk or such a thing. Okay, that is. And on top of your head, there has to be some hard material so that you can save yourself from such debris, from such stones, from because of the earthquake, the boulders that are falling. Okay, so this strong roof, okay, desk of course will be performing like a roof for you. So this strong roof can help you, right, help you get out of this situation, get out, or that is the only thing that you have in your hand, that is to save yourself. And how can you save yourself? Getting yourself covered under some hard material or hard roof. So here, whatever the material, that is a table, the desk, whatever you get, you will cover yourself under that so that you don't get injured by the boulders that are falling, right? So what to do before an earthquake? Now, when you know a particular area, okay, is prone to earthquake, Okay, so what could be done before an earthquake? Repair the deep plaster cracks in ceilings and foundations. Get expert advice if there are signs of structural defects. Now, not just the area, if the building is very old enough that we could actually see that it requires a lot of repairing, it is very old, a lot of cracks and falling ceilings are there, and if earthquake-like situation, even of a lighter magnitude, occurs, this building, particular building, is bound to fall off. If such is the situation, so you can avoid it before an earthquake by repairing the deep plaster cracks in ceilings and foundations. Get expert advice if there are signs of structural defects. Anchor overhead lighting fixtures to the ceiling. Follow the Bureau of Indian Standard codes relevant to your area for building standards. Okay, so that with those codes, with those earthquake with those codes, the earthquake resistant structures also have to be built, and with the help of those codes, you need to repair and rehabilitation of that particular building or an house has to be done. Fasten the shelves securely to walls. Place large or heavy objects on lower shelves, right? So that if an earthquake occurs and such large and heavy objects are at the top shelves, falling of them can injure people and create a havoc. So mostly the large and heavy objects has to be kept on the lower shelves so that they will not affect or they will not make someone injured during the earthquake situation when they fall off. Okay, then store the breakable items such as bottled foods, glass and china in low closed cabinets with latches. Okay, with latches you have to store it in closed cabinets because they are breakable items. They easily will break down and then the situation will worsen. If you have this bottle foods, the glass items, the china clay items, so they will break off easily by falling down. So they has to be kept in closed cabinets with latches. Hang heavy items such as pictures and mirrors away from the beds. Some cities, I mean sitting arrangement, wherever you have beds, wherever you have sitting arrangement, anywhere where the people sit, the heavy items like the pictures, the frames, the mirrors, they don't have to be kept near that. Correct, because earthquake can occur at any time. It doesn't give you a warning sign of a particular time for which it will occur. It will occur for few seconds or max to max minute, but it will occur at any time. Okay, so you might be in any situation. So basically, where people sit, the sitting arrangement is made at homes. So there, you don't have to keep these heavy items hanging. Heavy items or items, the breakable items, items like pictures, the picture frames, mirrors, okay, they don't have to be kept near to the sitting arrangement so that if such situation of earthquake occurs, they are easily going to get fallen and broken off. So they might injure the people sitting in those sitting arrangement area. So they have to be kept away from that. Then brace the overhead light and fan fixtures, very properly bracing attachment. Okay, repair the defective electrical wiring and leaky gas connection. These are potential fire risk. Then secure the water heaters, LPG cylinders, etc. by strapping them to the walls or bolting to the floor. Everything has to be secure, everything has to be hanged properly, proper bracing, proper attachment. Okay, secure store weed killers, pesticides and flammable products, you know, the insecticides or these pesticides or heat and all, whatever you use at your homes, they are actually the flammable products. Okay, they catch fire easily. Okay, so they has to be kept in closed cabinets with latches and in bottom shelves. Okay, so that during the earthquake, it should not happen that they are falling from some top shelves and then catching fire because they might, you know, they are gaseous things. That can catch fire easily, so that should not happen. So they have to be kept in closed cabinet with latches and on bottom shelves. Then identify safe places indoors and outdoors. This is before an earthquake, right? So you need to identify which are the secure, safe places indoors and outdoors. They're like under strong dining table. So when you know the preparedness, when you talk about, so indoor places and outdoor places where you can secure yourself when such earthquake occurs. So under a strong dining table or bed, like under the desk we just saw in that picture when students were in school, they secured themselves under the desk because desk is the hard material, right? That will secure them from injury. Likewise, identify such places like strong dining table or bed against an inside wall, away from where glass could shatter. Do not, or whenever an earthquake occurs, the glass, the window panes, you should not be near to them. Okay, away from where glass could shatter and windows, mirror, pictures, or where heavy bookcases or other heavy furniture could fall over. Right? In the open, away from the buildings, trees, right? When you are in the outdoors, in the open, you must secure yourself away from buildings, trees, telephone, electrical lines, flyovers, bridges. Know the emergency telephone numbers, such as those of doctors, hospitals, and police, etc. Educate yourself and your family members. So that is the simple do's and don'ts that you can do before an earthquake, right? Then have a disaster emergency kit ready. Disaster emergency kit ready. That is battery operated torch with extra batteries, battery operated radio, first aid kit and manual, emergency food, that is the dry food items and water packed and sealed, candles and matches in waterproof container, knife, chlorine tablets or powder water purifiers, can openers, essential medicines. So disaster emergency kit has to be kept ready. Now, where people are living in earthquake prone areas, they have to have this emergency kit ready with them. Then cash and credit cards, thick ropes and cords, study shoes, all this has to be there in the disaster emergency kit. Then develop an emergency communication plan. All this we are talking about the before disasters, before earthquake step, huh? Before earthquake occurrence. So develop an emergency communication plan. In case family members are separated from one another during an earthquake, a rare possibility during the day when adults are at work and children are at school. Right? This is a real situation that family members could be separated. Then develop a plan for reuniting after the disaster. Ask an out-of-state relative or friend to serve as the family contact after the disaster. It is often easier to call long distance. Make sure everyone in the family knows the name, address, and phone number of the contact person. So that is called an emergency communication plan. That is, we don't know when the earthquake occurs. And if it occurs during the daytime, everyone is busy in their own routine. So family members are not together mostly. Some are in the office, some are in the home, some children are in the schools. So everyone is separated, right? So how, and we know when such disaster situation occurs, the first thing that gets interrupted is the communication network. So people are not able to, even the family members becomes the situation like that they cannot even contact. So for this emergency communication plan, you keep a few contacts ready, basically one important contact ready, which is long distance contact, of course, in not that in particular area. Then it's of no use. There also will be no network connection. Keep one emergency contact ready who stays far away from your area, but is a close relative, and so that you can contact them. Everyone could mutually contact them to tell your own situation or your your situation or where you are. You can contact with them easily. Everyone could mutually contact with them. Okay, so that is develop an emergency communication plan. Make sure everyone of the family knows their name, address and phone number of that contact person. Then, help your community get ready. Publish a special section in your local newspaper with emergency information on earthquake. Okay, because earthquake, it's not like that it will occur only in a building. It will occur in an area. So that whole community will be affected. So help your community get ready. Publish a special section in your local newspaper with emergency information on earthquake. Localize the information by printing the phone numbers of local emergency services, offices, and hospitals. Conduct week-long series on locating hazards in the home. Work with local emergency services and officials to prepare special reports for people with mobility impairment and on what to do during an earthquake. Okay, so that way you can increase the awareness in the community, right? What to do and what not to do, which has to be published in the local newspaper. Week-long series on locating the hazards, a series demonstrating or, you know, publicizing that how to locate this hazard areas in your area, prone areas in your home. Then work with local emergency services and officials to prepare special reports for people with mobility impairment, for people who cannot evacuate, who cannot move from that area easily. So what they can do when such situation occurs, so they some special reports for those people has to be made. Provide tips on conducting earthquake drills in the home. Drills, right? Very important. Mock drills, what we were talking about previously as well, that you make a situation like that and help people, get people trained on how to deal with it. So conduct earthquake drills in the home. Interview representatives of the gas, electric, and water companies about shutting off utilities. Work together in your community to apply your knowledge to building codes, retrofitting programs, hazard hunts, and neighbor and family emergency plan. So that way you can make your community, not just the people, even the electrical, water companies, gas companies. Okay, so when you talk about community, it is combination of all people living in that area. So how you can make them ready for such situation, right? Then, all this was before the earthquake occurs. Now, what to do during an earthquake? Stay as safe as possible during an earthquake. Be aware that some earthquakes are actually foreshocks and a larger earthquake might occur. Minimize your movement to few steps that reach a nearby safe place and stay indoors until shaking has stopped and you are sure exiting is safe. Okay, so that is, be aware, you know, first the earthquake starts with some initial movements, actual foreshocks, and then leads to larger earthquake. Okay, so do not immediately move after the movement has reduced. It's not like that the movement has reduced and the earthquake has stopped and you can move out. It might happen that following those slow movements, there might be a larger earthquake. So always find yourself in a nearby safe place. Do not move until you're sure about it that the movement has completely stopped and you're exiting area where you want to go is safe and nearby. Then in indoors, if you are inside the building, your home or any structure, I mean if you are indoors, drop to the ground, take cover by getting under a study table. Just now we have seen in that picture as well, that is, drop to the ground, take cover by getting under a study hard table or other piece of any furniture and hold on until the shaking stops. If there is no table or desk near you, cover your face and head with your arms and crouch in an inside corner of the building. The outside walls, the glass, the window panes, okay, the outside ones are likely, of course they are likely to get crushed first, then the inside one. So if there is no table or desk near you, cover your face and head, because that is the one thing very important that might, if get hurt, you that might cause a death situation as well. So cover your face and head with your arms and crouch in an inside corner of the building. Correct? Then protect yourself by staying under the lintel of an inner door, in the corner of a room, or under a table, or even under a bed. Okay, so same similar like that, you can secure yourself under some structure. Okay, then as I told you, always stay away from this window panes, outside door, outside whatever is at the external area, say glass, window panes, outside doors and walls, anything that could fall, such as lighting fixtures or furniture. So stay away from that. Stay in bed if you are there when earthquake strikes. Hold on and protect your head with a pillow, unless you are under a heavy light fixture that could fall. In that case, move to the nearest safe place. Understood? So if you are on bed and when earthquake occurs and you don't have a sturdy table or anything that you can take a hard shelter of, okay, so what you can do, first of all, check if there is any falling or hanging fixture above you that could easily fall. So if that is the scene, move to some safer place. If you don't have anything that could fall easily, or any hanging or any light fixture, so protect your head with a pillow. Use a doorway for shelter only if it is in close proximity to you, and if you know it is strongly supported load-bearing doorway. Stay inside until the shaking stops and it is safe to go outside. Research has shown that most injuries occur when people inside the building attempt to move to a different location inside the building or try to leave. Okay, so situation worsens when people become panic, they start moving through the building and find some exit to go out, and then there occurs such a worse situation in an earthquake. Rather than doing that, stay inside and secure yourself under some hard structure. Or this saves, like we have just seen, the basic ways how you can secure yourself. Be aware that the electricity may go out, or the sprinkler system or fire alarms may turn on if you are outdoor. So that was if you are indoor and when earthquake occurs. So during an earthquake, what you can do. Now, if you are outdoors, do not move from where you are. However, move away from buildings, trees, street lights, and utility wires. Okay, if you are outdoors and earthquake occurs, do not panic, do not start moving here and there. Just make sure that you are away from buildings, trees, street lights, and utility wires. If you are in open space, stay there until the shaking stops. That is the best thing. If you are in the open space and shaking, that is earthquake situation occurs, but there is nothing that could fall down and injure you, so be there. The greatest danger exists directly outside the building, at exits and alongside the exterior walls. Most earthquake-related casualties, that is it, patients, the deaths, result from collapsing walls, flying glass, and falling objects. Now, if you are in a moving vehicle, if you are in a car, say, if you are in a moving vehicle, stop as quickly as safety permits and stay in the vehicle. Do not move here and there when earthquake situation occurs. If you are in a vehicle, stop as quickly as safety permit and stay in the vehicle itself. Avoid stopping near or under building, trees, overpasses, utility wires, because of course they are likely to get fallen when earthquake occurs. So do not stop your vehicle near the building, trees, overpasses, and utility wires. Proceed cautiously once the earthquake has stopped. Avoid roads, bridges, or ramps that might have been damaged by the earthquake. Right? Of course, the damage infrastructure, that is damage roads, bridges, ramps, has to be avoided after which are damaged by the earthquake, and move slowly, cautiously, once the earthquake has stopped. Now, if you are trapped under the debris, following these do's and don'ts, and now if you are trapped under the debris, under those whole boulders, okay, what you can do? Do not light a match. Do not move about or kick up dust. Cover your mouth with a handkerchief or some clothing. Tap on a pipe or a wall. Tap, okay, on a pipe or wall, whatever is near you, so rescuers can locate you. Use a whistle if one is available. Shout only as a last resort. Shouting can cause you to inhale dangerous amount of dust. Because when earthquake occurs, a lot amount of dust is generated, okay? And because of that, your breathing problems occur, suffocation occurs, and people then fall, I mean, then get much injured in such situation. So if you are trapped under the debris, first of all, make sure you are not inhaling the dust so much. So cover your mouth. Make sure shouting is not the one thing that you should do, because that will lead to much of the inhaling. We know that rescuers will be available in few time at that particular area. So make sure you can indicate them by some methods like tapping on the wall, tapping on the pipe, whistling. Okay, of course, shouting has to be kept the last priority if such options are not available. Do not light a match. Just to indicate that you are here, do not light a match, because as we told that it might occur that there are broken electrical wires, some flammable items nearby. Okay, so do not light a match so that it avoid something that could catch fire. Okay, so that was the basic do's and don'ts when earthquake like scenario occurs, right? Then, sorry, landslides. So we had seen floods, we had seen earthquake, landslide. So that is also the common phenomena. So for landslides, what are the basic do's and don'ts? Avoid, first of all, what you will do, that is avoid building houses near steep slopes, close to mountain edges, near drainage ways, or along natural erosion valleys. We know which particular area are more, or which geographical location is much more prone to get damaged during landslide. So avoid building your houses near steep slopes, close to mountain edges, near drainage ways, or along natural erosion valleys. Avoid going to places affected by debris flow. In mud flow areas, build channels to direct the flow around the buildings. When you know there is some debris flow, that is the landslide has occurred, avoid going to such area. And in the mud flow, in the landslide, the whole land, the boulders are, get slides over. In mud flow, it is a mud semi-solid form that flows. So build channels to direct this flow around the buildings. That is, move, do not, they should make some flow for that mud flow to get diverted from the buildings. Stay alert and awake. Many deaths from landslides occurs while people are sleeping. So stay alert and awake. Listen to unusual sounds that might indicate moving debris, such as trees cracking or boulders knocking together. If you have no option and you are staying at a landslide susceptible area, if you are staying at the mountain steep slopes, so you have to be alert and awake. You have to listen to some unusual sounds that might indicate moving debris, such as trees cracking or boulders knocking together, right? Move away from the landslide path or debris flow as quickly as possible. Avoid river valleys and low-lying areas. Any person near a stream or channel, be alert for any sudden increase or decrease in the water flow and notice whether the water changes from clear to muddy. So that is also the indication, right? Avoid river valleys and the low-lying areas where the flow will occur, flow of the debris will occur. Any person near a stream or channel, be alert for any sudden increase or decrease in the water flow or notice whether the water changes from clear to muddy. Okay, then go to designated public shelter if you have been told to evacuate. if the rescuers, if the officials have told you to evacuate your own house and move to a public shelter, do it. Then stay away from the slide area as there may be danger of additional slides. Okay, it's not just like here shown in the mountainous area. If this one particular section where the landslide has occurred, so you don't have to move from here to some other steepy slope. No. If the landslide has occurred along this steep slope, of course it might occur in another steep slopes also. So stay away from the slide area as there may be danger of additional slides. Okay, check the injured and the trapped person near the slide without entering the direct slide area. Check for the trapped people, but do not you yourself enter into that direct slide area, because our first thing is to contact the rescuers, the relief operation people. Okay, so we will stop our lecture here.